How crucial do you think your pictures of her helped establish her as an icon?
Well, some of those pictures were early on, were in like Cream magazine, and people saw them before they heard the music. So that was always there.
But do you think that your pictures had anything special that helped her to do that compared with the other photographers' pictures?
Well, I don't know. There's some really great pictures of her by other photographers. She's really striking what she looks like, and her relationship to the camera has always been, interesting, I guess. It's what it is.
And do you think it's still possible to have a scene like the one you were part of?
Yeah, I think they're with the internet, it's just faster now, and there's no chance for a scene to develop. What happened to Seabees? We all were there for years before there was any exposure. The same with Liverpool and maybe even Seattle a little bit with Nirvana and those guys. Now everything is immediately out in front of the world as soon as it's created in a way.
Do you think that not having a chance to develop makes scenes, I don't know, less consistent in a way?
Maybe, but it's the new paradigm. So things develop online instead of in public so much. But it's just faster. People, kids are kind of used to that now. It is making for this short attention span with the young people. I don't know, I don't know if that's a good thing, but it's what it is, and it's what people are dealing with.
How an established band has to get involved with these different paradigms in these times.
As Clem says, which I agree with, is rock and roll is sort of like jazz now. It's a much more limited, it's a niche market.
Yeah.
But then you see, like Miley is doing all rock and roll. She's great. I'm a big fan. I think it's terrific.
Have you met her?
I talked to her online a little bit.
But it would be great to have her and you playing together. That would
Yeah,
be.
maybe sometime. I know she's a big fan. I know she's has a bunch of my photos, actually.